and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day.
We begin our prayer on this feast of Corpus Christi, the body and blood of Christ, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God our Father and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you always. The humble offering of bread and wine that we bring to this altar will become the sign of our new covenant with God. While we cannot hope to fathom the depths of this mystery, we can enter into it with faith, joy, and gratitude for the saving body and blood of the Lord. And so we pray, Lord Jesus, you are the Paschal Lamb sacrificed for us. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, your flesh is true food and your blood is true drink. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood, giving us eternal life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In those days, Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought out bread and wine, and being a priest of God Most High, he blessed Abram with these words: Blessed be Abram by God Most High, the creator of heaven and earth, and blessed be God Most High, who delivered your foes into your hand. Then Abram gave him a tenth of everything. The word of the Lord.
Everlasting. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, also the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Jesus spoke to the crowds about the kingdom of God, and he healed those who needed to be cured. As the day was drawing to a close, the 12 approached him and said, "Dismiss this crowd so that they can go to the surrounding villages and farms and find lodging and provisions, for we are in a deserted place here." He said to them, "Give them some food yourselves." They replied, "Five loaves and two fish are all we have, unless we ourselves go and buy food for all these people." Now the men there numbered about 5,000. Then he said to his disciples, "Have them sit down in groups of about 50. They did so and made them all sit down. Then, taking the five loaves and the two fish, and looking up to heaven, he said the blessing over them, broke them, and gave them to the disciples to set before the crowd. They all ate and were satisfied. And when the leftover fragments were picked up, they filled 12 wicker baskets." The Gospel of the Lord. When I think of home, I think of a place where there is love overflowing. I've chosen this very short lyric from Broadway's The Wiz because I truly believe that it very much addresses the two events that we gather to celebrate today, namely Father's Day and the Feast of Corpus Christi. If you'll allow me, I'd like to draw a few comparisons between the home our dads provide for us and the home the body of Christ finds in our hearts and souls, especially in those who believe. For the most part, our dads spend their lifetime making sure that there was a roof over our heads, a meal on our tables, and shirts on our backs. They work tirelessly to provide for our every need. Not nearly as expressive as our moms, our father's love has many dimensions, everything from an affirming smile to an approving and supportive nod or even simply a pat on the back. Expecting absolutely nothing in return, our dads quietly take their place behind the scenes, while proudly observing all that we do and all that we become. They are, I think, the silent force behind every goal, every achievement, and each and every one of our accomplishments, great and small. On this Father's Day, may we be ever grateful for their guidance, protection, example, and love, past and present. I truly believe they are our home, and they always will be. Now, as I mentioned a moment ago, today is also the Feast of Corpus Christi, the body and blood of Jesus Christ. It's a day for all of us, especially those who believe, to celebrate and affirm our faith in the real presence of Christ, lovingly shared with each and every one of us every time we approach this altar to receive the Blessed Sacrament. Like our fathers, Jesus, the body of Christ, is our home, our sanctuary, our place of refuge, and we are his as we consume and become the sacred body of Christ. So you see, I really do think that there are some parallels to be made between the bread winners and the bread of life. I hope you'll agree that today is as good a day as any to open our hearts and our souls to both in gratitude and with deep reverence and respect. As I began this sermon with one lyric, I hope you'll allow me to close with another that I have been singing to our fathers on Father's Day for the past 37 years as a tribute to my dad and to yours, Dan Fogelberg's leader of the band. I thank you for the music and your stories of the road. I thank you for the freedom when it came my time to go. I thank you for the kindness and the times when you got tough. And Papa, I don't think I said I love you near enough. The leader of the band is tired and his eyes are growing old, but his blood runs through my instrument and his song is in my soul. My life has been a poor attempt to imitate the man. I'm just a living legacy to the leader of the band. I am a living legacy to the leader of the band. To all of our fathers here present and those who have gone before us, a happy and blessed Father's Day. Let us stand now and together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. God of hosts, you know us, love us, and provide for our daily bread. And so we have the courage to call on your name in prayer.
For all members of the church, may they better recognize and embrace the communal element of Christ's sharing of himself in the Eucharist. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our human family, May the hungry be fed abundantly from the table of humanity and the table of God's blessings. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our fathers, grandfathers, and all who have fathered and guided us through our lives. For those living and those who have passed on to eternal life. May they experience God's blessings in abundance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this body of Christ, may we realize there is always enough when we use the gifts God has given. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those of our parish family and friends who are ill, infirmed, or hospitalized, for a respect for all life from conception to natural death, for an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life, for those serving our country and their loved ones, for the members of our parish prayer ministry, for our own prayers, and for all petitions written in our Book of Intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For our living and deceased fathers during this month of remembrance, we pray to the Lord. For our beloved dead and those who mourn them, and today for the deceased members of the Chesnolavich family who are lovingly remembered at this Mass, we pray to the Lord. O God, our source of strength and consolation, in you we live and move and have our being. In your mercy we ask that you hear our prayers and nourish us at your table, that we may have the strength to live our lives dedicated to your service. We pray this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we here present. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest, who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, the religious, the clergy, and your entire people. Remember also our brothers and sisters, our fathers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles, Saint Teresa, Saint Francis Cabrini, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Alleluia.
Pray for our fathers, living and deceased, in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And with your spirit. Offer to one another a gesture of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Thank you. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Our parish holy hour will be held this Wednesday evening at 6:30 here in the church. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Amen.